Will gold be below $1,000 by the end of this year? Hey guys, it's May 14th, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcad. Jeff Cox of CNBC.com produced an article called Gold to Fall Below $1,000 by End of Year. The first sentence is really, really hilarious. Quote, strengthen the U.S. dollar and stability in a European bailout will take the steam out of gold's recent run and send prices below $1,000 by year's end, one economics firm says. And speaking of stability, France's president, Nicolas Sarkozy, threatened to pull France out of the euro. According to a Spanish newspaper, he threatened to pull France out of Europe. Well, he basically said that commitment from everybody to support Greece is really, really important. If people didn't increase their commitment to support Greece, then essentially France would have to reconsider its position in the euro. So I don't know if you can really call that stability when people are threatening to pull out. But anyway, okay, the oil spill. Now, Transocean, the company that owned that Deepwater Horizon drill that sank into the ocean and sort of helped cause this whole mess, Transocean is citing an 1851 law to limit its spill liability. They filed a petition in federal court in Houston that will allow the federal government to cap their overall liability to less than $27 million, which is a great deal considering the damage that's being done by this. If they're successful, they'll receive insurance money to the point of $533 million. Holy smokes. That's one heck of a bailout. I hate to be that insurance company, really. But at this point, there's reports that the Gulf spill is reportedly up to 70,000 barrels per day. We don't know how this is really going to affect not only the environment, but the economy. And the thing is, what makes this different from Katrina is that we don't really see the immediate results. We're not going to see the full damage up close until maybe a month from now. So we don't know if this thing is going to get caught up in a Gulf Stream. We don't know what to expect from this. Okay, foreclosures. Foreclosures actually declined 9% in April. Now, this is compared to a record in March. But still, the foreclosures are still pretty high. They were at 333,837. That's still a hell of a lot. This is a number compared. It's actually down 9% compared to March, but like I said, March was a record. And it's still pretty high. Anyway, the budget. In April, they saw a deficit of $83 billion. $83 billion. Just to provide some perspective, last April, they had a deficit of $20.9 billion. Basically, the income fell by 8%, and the spending increased by 14%. So that gives you an idea of which direction we're going. The Afghanistan war is costing more than Iraq. Now, In the 2008 fiscal year, Iraq was three times as expensive as Afghanistan. In the 2009, it was twice as expensive, twice as costly. Well, this year, according to the Pentagon, in February, the military spent $6.7 billion on Afghanistan and $5.5 billion on Iraq. They're putting more soldiers into Afghanistan. They're dealing with a much more difficult terrain. So the costs are going up. Okay. Attorney General Andrew Cuomo of New York is trying to figure out if banks provided agencies with false information in order to keep better ratings on their risky securities. They're basically launching an investigation, and Cuomo's office is looking into Goldman Sachs, Morgan Stanley, USB AG, Citigroup, Deutsche Bank, part of Bank of America, Merrill Lynch. It'll be pretty interesting. I hope he comes up with something, if there is something to be found. But I have a feeling there is something to be found. Okay, job growth at the military base, Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, is actually going to add 1,200 jobs. 953 of them are going to be civilian positions. So somebody is hiring, even in this economy. But as people are hiring, there's a lot more people laying people off. In San Diego, a ship builder is planning on laying off 900 people. This is the West Coast's last big ship builder. And it's in San Diego County. And like I said, they're going to lay off 900 people. Sena is going to cut 140 jobs. Jordan School District is going to cut 190 jobs. Drug company Takeda is going to cut 1,600 jobs. 500 of them are going to be in the Chicago area. Yeah, there's more. Okay, there's going to be 500 jobs lost in a furniture plant in Henry County. The Health and Hospital Corporation head is announcing that there's going to be some cutoffs in New York. They're going to cut off about 500 jobs in New York. The Charlotte area is going to lose about 500 teachers because of layoffs. Long Beach School District is going to issue 243 pink slips, mostly teachers. Chevron is going to cut 925 jobs in East Bay. Port of Baltimore is going to cut 116 jobs. Legg Madison is going to cut 250 jobs. And there's more, but we don't have all day. So that's what's going on so far. Guys, thank you for watching this video. I have a question. Do you think that this oil spill is going to be Obama's Katrina? And what do you think the full effect of this oil spill is going to be? How do you think it's going to affect the economy? Do you think it's going to be picked up by the Gulf Stream? I want to know what you guys think about this. So, all right, guys. Thank you for watching this video. Have a good day. And remember, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.